Hey there, today on the workshop I'm going to show you guys how to make a very cheap and very useful hobby paint shaker. Now what you see in front of you is everything you need. You need a cheap single speed or variable speed jigsaw. This was out of my shop. I have a really nice variable speed laser with a laser skill saw now. This old Black & Decker has been my faithful in the wood shop for at least 25 years. This goes way back into the 90s. When I was just getting into woodworking, and it still works great, it's still powerful and everything, but I don't use it anymore. And instead of throwing it away or taking it to the thrift shop, which is another place you can pick these up at, these single speed Black & Deckers, any brand name, Benchtop from Kmart in the old days, anywhere, you can get these things for less than $10 at a garage sale, thrift store, Goodwill. People get rid of these all the time. So go ahead and get yourself one of these. This right here is a Harbor Freight speed clamp. They don't cost anything. That's the short, like the 9-inch clamp, as long as they have the open end like that. They don't cost you a thing. You have a coupon, you go in, you buy some gloves or some equipment for doing modeling, some razor blades, and get one of these for free. If you had to buy it, it'll set you back a whole 99 cents. So I'm going to show you how to take these parts and make a very nice and very effective model hobby paint shaker. First, what you want to do is you want to take the foot off the jigsaw. We don't need this, and it actually reduces the size of the bottle that you can put on it. So you just unscrew it, and you'll have to look at the shoe that your jigsaw comes with. Might take 3 or 4 screws, but it just comes off that easy. Okay, discard that, throw it in metal recycling, or save it, because it only takes a few seconds to convert this back to a workable jigsaw, so you could have both in the same world. Then, of course, we need to remove the blade because we're not going to be cutting anything. We're just going to take the blade off and toss it. Then we're going to open those jaws all the way open. Then all we need to do is take the clamp and insert it. I didn't open the jaw all the way, or as far as I should have, for this exact tool. Now, be careful when you're clamping this back down, because, like on this one, the jaws aren't steel for the blade. They're actually like a cast aluminum. So you don't want to crack them, because they'll crack if you compress them too hard. But just tighten that screw down, and that'll hold in there plenty tight. It's not going to go anywhere. It's not, I mean, it's, you can actually force the motor to move before you're going to get that to fumble out of there. And that's it. That's it. You've made your paint shaker. Your paint shaker is ready to go. Now, this is a single speed, and on the back it says it saws at 3,200 saws per minute, or, in its new purpose, 3,200 shakes per minute. Now, we've all seen model paint separate, okay? This is definitely separated. This is an earth brown. We've got brown on the bottom, but we've got nothing but carrier on the top. Now, shaking it up by hand takes a while, and you don't always get it perfectly mixed because you just can't shake your hands that fast. They've got those little dip-in paint stirrers and everything, but of course those spin, those make a mess, you can stir it by hand, whatever. This is cheap and easy, and it allows you to save a lot of paints that you'd otherwise have to toss, or you wouldn't get as much use out of. Now you just put it in the clamp as you would put anything in the clamp, and clamp it down tight. Now, for demonstration purposes, we're going to do this on the workbench, so let's hope that everything doesn't go to hell in a handbasket, or I'm going to have one big mess here. But make sure the lids are on tight and the glass isn't cracked. Obviously, you'll have to plug it in. So let me rig that out. I didn't want to plug it in while I was taking the blade off or anything, because losing fingers is not cool. So we've got it in there. Now, let's normally I do this over a shopping bag, and that would be common sense. But I'll turn it on right now, and we'll just see it shake the paint up for us, and we'll take a look at it. See now what happened there? If I had it over the shopping bag, I wouldn't have gone flying. But the little foot came off, and that's fine. It didn't hurt anything. But now look at the paint. It's completely mixed after only a few seconds, top to bottom. You left it on there another 10 seconds, it'd be perfectly mixed. Open it up. Good enough to eat in there. Perfect mix. The carrier's back in the solvent, and we're all good. Now, when I get this back together, and it's hilarious because it's never flown apart before until now. That's what's hilarious, is it only has done it on camera. This will even fit the large craft bottles we like to use. If you lower it all the way down. Okay, and tighten it up. Make sure it's centered in there. Tighten it up. and turn that on, you can see where it's kind of separated near the top there. Take it out, all mixed beautifully. Yeah, baby. Yeah. Perfectly mixed, no mess, no fuss. If it wouldn't have come loose the first time, now we're going to give it a real test. Look at this. This is gloss enamel gold. We're going to see if it can even fix this. I don't know if it can fix this at all. This bottle of paint has to be almost as old as I am. I swear I got this when I was just a kid, and somehow it got stored away in a box. I just found it when I started screwing around here. So let's see if we can even do anything with this. I don't think we can, but let's see what happens. Are you kidding me? It's good. I did not think that this super old gloss enamel. Oh my. Look at that. So, I just salvaged a bottle that's got to be near as old as I am of paint with a nearly free. I mean, for me, it's pretty much free because I've had this forever. And the clamp doesn't cost me anything. I grab a couple every time I go to Harbor Freight. So with this simple device and only running it a few seconds per bottle, think of all the money you could save and the bottles you can salvage. When you custom mix your paints, you know you're going to get a perfect shake. And we just did that gold. And look, it's not all full of bubbles either. You know, when you stick those other paint mixers in them, they introduce air into the bottle. And then what does that do? That introduces bubbles and it mixes them all up. This method, it doesn't do any of that. So hey, I'm glad that worked out. That was actually a happy accident. So you could salvage just about any type of paint, any brand name, up to the large craft paint bottles. Up, you know, this will fit the smaller Vallejo and Army Painter bottles. It'll fit in there. Anything you can think of will go in there and get shaken up and work perfectly. So thanks for watching my how-to of the homemade, the DIY, Hobby Paint Shaker. Thanks for watching the workshop.